Sway in the Morning, Shade 405. Yes, yes, yes. Heather, a friend of the show, somebody who's been by the show before, that I really, really enjoyed the conversation we had. Got a new project called the Aaron LP, which is out right now. And I was just curious to see, what did he do? How did he grow since he came here last? And it just so happens that he happened to be here the day after the first game of the NBA Finals with the Golden State Warriors and the Toronto Raptors. And he's actually, if I'm not mistaken, from Canada. So this was a setup. I just wanted to beat up somebody from Canada since we lost last night.
That's why you got that jersey on?
That's why I wore the jersey, because I knew he was going to be here today to talk about his new project. Welcome, Sun Real, back, ladies and gentlemen.
Sun Real!
Thank you guys so much for having me, honestly. Thank you, Sway.
Absolutely.
Thanks, guys. Thanks, Heather.
Yeah, well, you've been watching this stuff, man? You see how the Raptors cheated last night? Did you see this at all?
Whoa, cheat?
Mm-hmm. You know what?
No.
Honestly, I did an all-nighter. I had a show in Portland, and I guess not last night, but the night before, and we just flew to New York that night, and I can't sleep on planes. And I did, like, press and stuff all day yesterday, and I did, like, a show thing at night, and I was so beat that I just told my manager, Byron, I was like, just text me the score. I'm going to go to sleep. And I just went to the hotel and went to sleep. But we won. Sorry, man.
You see, that's what I'm saying. Just text me the score. Are they even real fans? You know what I mean? Like,
no.
Text me the score?
I'm a real fan, but man, I need to be on point for today. So
I'm not mad at that. Get your money. He's staying focused.
Hey. Focused.
Portland, Oregon, you were in last night? Or Portland, Maine?
Not last night, the night before. Portland, Oregon,
Portland, Oregon.
Yeah.
And so is that what you've been doing lately? Performing a lot? Or?
Yeah, I'm on a world tour right now, man. So we just started. I'm only like 5 shows in, but it's been good. It's like my first time like really doing solid tickets throughout America. And like I just put out the Aaron LP, and it's like a really different body of work for me. Wow. And kind of took a step out of what I'd been doing previously. And it's translating, man. Like my Spotify numbers and Apple Music numbers and everything across the board have just went like way higher than anything I've ever done before. And it's kind of just a testament to me, I think, just being more honest with my fan base. And it's got us a lot of new fans, and it feels really good.
Being more honest with your fan base, this is interesting, because this is a step away from One Long Dream, right? This isn't the same approach at all to it. I was, you know, the one thing that I noticed first and foremost, I feel like it's a guitar through every song.
Yeah.
Just about that. Is, I don't know if it's acoustic, but it seemed like it's signature. It's a signature thread throughout this whole album.
Yeah.
If I don't, you know, I kind of feel like genres are becoming a thing of the past now, would you say?
100%. 100%.
Yeah.
I think, like, even to give a genre to, I mean, and even look at, like, back in the day, like, people like Bob Dylan and all sorts of artists, like, back in the day, they would do an album that sounded like this genre, and then they would go do something completely different, and they would get ridiculed for it at the very start, and then they became classics, right? And everybody sings them. And even when Kanye did like 808,
I was just about to mention that
everyone hated it. I didn't even like it. I remember I was like, I just was like, I was looking for, you know, College Dropout and that kind of stuff, and it's one of my favorite Kanye albums.
Even Jesus too.
Yeah. So I mean, honestly, it's kind of scary, like, doing something that's different than what you're kind of known for and what my fan base loved me for. But I went and did it. It's a lot more singing. It's kind of guitar and B kind of vibes. And it's like I don't even have, like, I'm like scrolling through comments and all this kind of stuff, and nobody's hating. So I'm just like, this is great.
Damn, you're going through comments.
I'd be going through comments. I'm petty like that.
I just had a conversation last night about different. Like, what's so scary about it? Are you worried about, or we're worried about feedback, what other people are going to think? What's the scary part about being different and doing something different?
Well, I think it's just, you get known for something and you build a career off of it. You're paying your friends and you're paying, you know, people that are working for you, and you want to be successful.
Mm-hmm.
And you get successful off of something and you feel almost the urge to like repeat that and like do it to a bigger level or whatever. And for me, I was just like, I just want to go where my heart wants to go. I wrote this whole album like I was writing it in a room by myself. Like I was just talking to a wall. Like I was just I had nobody telling me, oh, we need a record like this, oh, like this. It's just like I wanted to make a body of work that was cohesive. That's why it's like so guitar based, and that's why the mixes and everything, the transitions between songs and everything feels really cohesive, because I really wanted to make a body of work that felt like something and was my own sound. And this is my first time, I think, finding my own sound. One Long Dream was, in my opinion, and this is just me being honest, but it was very disconnected. Like, there was great songs on it,
uh-huh.
and then there were songs that sounded like this and songs that sounded like this, and a song from a different era like 2 years before,
uh-huh.
and I just kind of like threw stuff at the wall and like hope something stuck, kind of. I felt like with this album I think I was very deliberate, and uh-huh. I think it's just showing, like, it's translating, like, well, people are loving it.
Well, yeah, well, you mentioned being in a room by yourself, so when you have titles like Fearless and Quit, was it therapeutic too at the same time?
Yeah, yeah, and I mean, music's always been that for me, but
okay.
I think to the next level on this one. For like to the next level, like I mean there were songs I had to like send my mom before like we went to mastering, being like, yo, are you cool with me like saying this, and mm-hmm. like I've never had to do that before, and mm-hmm. like even songs like I've never felt nervous in the studio before, like I always just like, you know, lots of the time I'll freestyle an idea or whatever and I'll never really get nervous. Some of these songs, like recording them, I had two producers in the room and I was like nervous because I didn't know what they were going to think about what I was saying. And like, it's just because you're just putting yourself out there to mm-hmm. the max. Like, things that my friends don't even know about me.
Right.
Were those songs, you know, like voicemail?
Yeah, that
voicemail,
was.
Voicemail, because.
That was one of them.
Voicemail, you talk about being raised by women. Mm-hmm. You didn't have a father in your life?
No, I did.
You did?
Yeah, my dad worked out of town, so he'd be gone like 4 or 5 months of the year lots of the time, and my parents didn't really get along that good growing up.
Okay.
They were always arguing and this and that, and but my dad was a good dad. Like, he did everything in his power to be a great dad, and he loved me, and but he had like crazy mental health issues that you know, were never taken care of or anything like that.
Uh-huh.
And he was a great guy, and he was a great dad, and I wrote a song about him before my album came out that was called My Friend, and it was all about him, and yeah, he passed away, but yeah, he's a great dude, and mm-hmm. But yeah, he wasn't around as much as my mom was and my two sisters. I have an older sister and a younger sister, Amanda and Katie.
And you talk about the influence they had on you as a man,
yeah.
being these great women that they are.
Yeah.
What are those influences, you think? How has it affected you in your relationships?
Just everything. They always just check you. When you got two sisters, they just check you. Like, when I first started rapping, like, they'd just be checking me all the time. Like, I would show them a song, like, because they're my best friends, too, you
hey.
Know? So it's like, I'll show them a song, and that, like, my little sister would just be like, why are you saying that? Like, that's not even you. And I'd be like, okay, yo, pull up. I'm going to do this then. Just, like, I was just so hungry. I was just I was 15 years old when I started rapping, so I was just so hungry, and I just wanted to express myself, and I was inspired by all the music I was inspired by, mm-hmm. that I was just saying crazy stuff, and they would
but
just
that wasn't
check
you
me.
Though it wasn't true though, right?
No, it wasn't even true, like, yeah. I was saying just anything, you know, uh-huh. anything to get attention, and they always used to check me, and I think they actually, like, yeah, they helped me grow, and I send them songs before they even come out and stuff. I'm like, yo, what do you think of this? And they'll say their opinions. My little sister loves every song on my album, except for she hates Dive Bar.
Okay.
She's like, I hate it. And I'm like, okay.
She hates that. I love your little sister. What's her name? Shout her out.
Katie Hoffman.
Katie. Special K.
Yeah.
Hey, if this album in the war season was put into a hip-hop category, and
yeah.
people in hip-hop were upset about that, would you agree with them? Would you understand where it came from, or...
I wouldn't put it in hip hop.
You wouldn't.
And I said that before the album came out. I was like,
okay.
I don't want this to be in hip hop.
I'd okay.
put it in pop before I put it in hip hop.
Okay.
Or I'd put it in R&B before I put it in hip hop.
Okay.
To be honest. And that's part of like the growth of me. And you know, it's growing pains. Like, it's like, it's exciting. It's an exciting time because I think I'm growing into the artist that I always kind of wanted to be.
And you use hip hop as a way to get there.
Yeah, I mean, hip-hop's everything to me. I come from hip-hop.
Yeah.
It's like, I would not be able to, and you can tell when I'm doing these songs, like, even when I'm singing that, I come from hip-hop with the cadences and the flows and even references and everything. Like, it's all I come from hip-hop. I love music mostly, though.
Mm-hmm.
I love music as a whole. I love everything from old music, like Stevie Wonder, and I love, like, Americana music, like Neil Young, and all the new guys coming out, like, you know, I love like Tyler Childers and uh-huh. Jason Isbell and lots of the new stuff like that. And I just listen to a lot of different types of music.
If you had won, would you have forfeited it?
If I had won rap? It's a hard question. I mean, well, I don't know. Yeah. I really don't know how to answer that because at this point, I wouldn't submit it for rap recording of the year.
Right.
In my opinion.
Son Real, he has a really great project that he put together from Fearless to Back to You. And it's interesting, some of those things you was asking him about, Heather B. I mean, he even says in Fearless, I don't sing the songs, those songs no more, hard times will never last. Were you talking about past songs or when you wrote that line?
You know, I'm speaking about my own like things that I've been through, but I'm also talking to my fans on that song. And you know, I get a lot of messages from fans all the time saying things like, "Yo, you know, I'm struggling right now. You know, my job isn't going good. I listen to you on my way to work because it makes me feel good." And like that to me is like, that's why I want to do music. I want to make people feel good. A lot of people feel anxiety right now. A lot of people feel depressed. And a lot of my fan base, they relate to my music and it makes them feel happy. And like, that's what I'm trying to achieve.
There it
is. I want to make people feel good.
Son Real. How can they follow you, Son Real?
At Son Real on Instagram. At The Real Son Real on Twitter. If you type in Son Real anywhere, you just get me.
S-O-N Real. Here's voicemail, Sway of the Morning, Shade 45. If you like this song, give us a call, 888-742-3345. His name is Son Real. The new album is the Aaron LP. Who's that last verse about?
That's about my wife.
That's about your wife. She didn't know who you were when you met her?
No, she know who I've known my wife. Okay. Who she was since I've been like maybe 7 or 8 years old.
Oh, so y'all grew up together or you just knew who she was?
Well, our older sisters are the same age and they played soccer together. And I would just see her sometimes like when I was at like the soccer games when we were like, I don't know, maybe like 9 or 10 or something. I don't even know.
That line you said, you taught me the power of being honest?
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah,
she did, man. That's deep, man, coming from a man. What does that mean?
Right, what was you lying about?
Well, I don't know. I don't know. I could get super deep, but like, yeah, I don't know. I had like commitment issues and all that kind of stuff. Like, I didn't really know where my career was gonna go, but I wanted to be with her, and like, she just always supported me so much, and was just like, yo, go, you know what I mean? She just like always stuck by my side, and it made me want to be more honest with who I was and go commit to things in my life. And that's why I proposed to her, and that's why I'm married to her now. Mm-hmm. She taught me that. She taught me how to feel. She taught me how to like just give my everything to people yeah. in my life, my friends, my family. She taught me how to give everything I have to people. And I don't think I could have wrote this album without, you know, her. So.
What do you think you taught your wife?
What have I taught my wife?
Yeah.
I think I've taught my wife quite a bit. if she was here, I mean, I'd like her to speak on that. But I think before I met my wife, I think she was a little bit more like closed a little bit. Like she wouldn't open up. I think I've opened up my wife. I think she's like much more open to, I think she's like a little bit more like, I don't know how to say it. She was just a little bit more shy before. I think now she's a little bit more outgoing.
Spontaneous.
Yeah. She's That's a little bit more extrovert than she was. And, I'd say I've made her better in every single way.
That is, Son Real. We got Teresa on the line from California.
Teresa,
good morning.
Hey, Teresa.
Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Hey.
What's going on?
Good morning.
You got a question for Son Real?
No, I just wanted to let him know. That's the first I've ever heard of him. So listening to your show in the morning and having to hear it on the way to work, that was pretty damn emotional. So he's right. I could feel that feeling. And talking from a mom's perspective, that was pretty emotional.
Cool, yo.
All the voicemails.
Oh, that's awesome. I appreciate you listening and connecting to it.
You know,
I didn't expect that. I mean, like you were saying, you know, you're the rap and the hip-hop R&B. I was, like, trying to listen for the flow and the music. But, damn, then your mom got on the voicemail. I'm like, oh, no, he didn't. You just got me all emotional on my way to work. That ain't right.
Yo, that means a lot. Honestly, like you listen to it and connecting to it like that means the world. That's all I wanted with that song.
It'll be even more if you go ahead and get his album, the Aaron LP.
Yeah, go get it.
Absolutely.
All right. Okay.
We got plenty more on that.
You're a citizen, Teresa. Jonathan. Jonathan Long Beach. John, what up?
What up, hey, John?
Hey, Slay. What's going on, brother? You know, I can appreciate that track, man, because coming from a single parent home and everything, my mom was my everything. She still is my everything, and I appreciate her on a daily basis, and that brother, that track touched me.
Really
did. And I can appreciate that, brother. God bless you, and I pray that your career prospers.
Thank you so much, man. It means the world. These are better responses than we got last time I was on Sway, so I'm happy already. Last time they were like, yeah, you can spiz, cool, or whatever. This time they're like,
oh. They real, bro. That's the citizens. John, you're a citizen.
Sway in the morning.
Let's take them to the Bronx, the birthplace of hip-hop. Don D, what up?
Hey, Don D.
Don Davis. What's up, Sway? Shay 45. This is Don D. 152. Sunside Chicken.
Not me.
You know? Yo, that was beautiful, my brother. Yo, that hit me to my heart. Yo, oh, that was real.
Dude, was thank real. You. Thank
that
you.
That was real, you know?
Go online, Don, go online and look up the Aaron LP by Sun Real.
Yeah.
This is just one of 10 songs on this project, man.
Yeah. And Sway?
Yes, sir.
You're doing a great job. And one more, I tried to get in touch with you yesterday. My man, Big Gov.
Blue Tears. Did you like that song? This is a song, man, we played in our Get in the Game segment. First time ever played.
Man, that hurt my heart.
Yeah.
That hurt my heart. I'm right there. I'm from the Bronx, man. 152. Story Avenue.
My man.
I live in the building where Miss Shakur and Tupac live at right now.
Oh wow!
That's hey. Fact. I'm up the block, around the corner from the juice bar, baby.
Okay, I see what you're saying. Shout out to Green Gardens on White Plains Road. Hey, John, you a citizen, man?
Sway in the morning.
Alicia, what do you think, man? Sun Real is here.
Sun Real, I love that song. As a college professor teaching college students every day, they don't expect me to like rap music, but I'm gonna tell you that touched me. I have 3 grown sons. And the fact that you put your mom in that, it really touched my heart. And on Monday morning, I'm playing that in my class.
Wow.
Wow. It's called voicemail.
Okay. Hey, that means a lot, man.
It's called voicemail. It's off the Aaron LP. Alicia, you're a citizen.
A Sway in the morning.
Yeah, they did get at you last time you came here, huh? They did say a few words about you, didn't they? But, you know, it's a different day now.
Yeah, straight up.
We don't sing those past songs no more. We on to something new.
Yeah.
But some things never change, Heather B. Anytime an MC step into the room, you gotta walk through the valley of the hyenas.
Let's go.
You are now entering the five fingers.
The moment
of
I've
death.
Been waiting.
DJ, five fingers?
Five fingers.
Meant to test your lyrical stamina.
Put him to the test.
I saw the look in his eyes. This guy's crazy.
Many have tried.
I'm the best.
Cross
this is just another chance
now.
For me to prove it.
But many have failed.
Give me some hip hop.
It's the five fingers of death.
Five beats designed to trip you up. We want to test your skills as an MC. If you come up here to Sway in the Morning, Shay 45, you can't forget where you came from.
Yeah.
Can't forget where you came from. Katie, what up? Sun Real.
I don't even know when this one drops. Is it drop?
It's coming now. Sun Real, Sway in the Morning, five fingers of death.
Hey. I don't do this for the glam, I don't do this for the bands. I get letters from my fans, putting life back in their hands. Define success, what you call bless. When I lost my pops, I almost quit this conquest. But he don't want me doing that, and quitting never been a hobby. That's as stupid as telling women what to do with their bodies. I don't write songs, I put my life in the public. Shining with a light on, go ahead, hate it or love it. Fuck it, I ain't even rapping on my new album. Watch me beast though. Shit I'm writing got my team flying right into Heathrow. Tattoos on the bodies of the words I'm writing deep though. Dreamt to get on Sway since I was 18 though. What you know about putting your all in? I put my mind to it till I be ballin'. Off more than money, cause money ain't never made me high. Like my wife did when I took a knee and I made her cry. Like coming to peace with someone you lose when you say goodbye. Like telling my mama there's a baby on the way and I'm gonna be the best daddy. Humble but I flex gladly. Talking songwriting put me with the best that don't at me. I put my work in this product. I don't take shit from nobody. I don't give shit unless they want it. Got some demons, they love me. They help me shoot like a comet. No one famous as they make it. Okay, let's just be honest. I'm singing. There's suicidal millionaires and building squares. I work for happiness, there ain't no ceiling there. My homies pulled up smiling in a wheeling chair. Told me ain't nobody taking shit from what you leaving here. And you might be, but greatness never hurry. Rest in peace to Mac Miller, some of us left us too early. I think about his parents surfing over all his songs. Nipsey left us, but he left us songs that will live on. I'll be damned if I don't use my platform to say some shit. They're gonna challenge how you think and treat each other in this bitch that we call life. I don't have the answers on my phone, cause every time that I go scroll, I see some people I don't know. And I'm scared of showing you, just like I'm scared of telling lies. That's why the album I just dropped ain't sound like nothing you can find. Take a little Nas mixed with John Prime. Feel like Jay-Z, I make the song cry every time my palm fly. And I've struck in the lotto. Sing with vibrato like I'm Demi Lovato. Used to whine like grapes, feeling that sorrow. Till that habit, I kick like fucking Ronaldo, ooh. Living life like we never wait for tomorrow. I ain't drowning in no sorrow, guzzling back a Sapporo. That's a celebration. This is story never ending, while these rappers looking like a taquito from 7-Eleven. Just sitting there, hoping that they get picked. Lower down their price tag every time they spit shit. Go and ask for double that. Settle for like a quarter of it. Put a fucking album out and couldn't get a quarter for it. Woo! Mr. Mistake evolved to Mr. Correction. Now every record he dropping, they call him Mr. Perfection. Started in Vancouver, how the hell I get to Texas? Flying with no Nexus line, so you know that I'm on my grind. Hearing rap with humility is really hard to find. Guess that not being too legendary ain't really what's on my time. Yeah, my style free like skin. I'm just a human being. But sometimes I wonder like Steven. If the song's in the key of life reading, the same way I wrote them, the same way I'm exploding. I got you on your back like yoga. Sway, you a legend, no doubt.
Hey!
Five fingers of death, I'm out.
No!
I must say, I couldn't really hear the beat that much, so I was like, I was chirping at the start. I was like, whoa!
That was really good.
Came off the top. I like that. Give it up for Son Real. Had the beat.
Man. I was like, what do you know about sorrow? But I forgot he was in Canada.
Yeah.
Straight up.
About sorrow.
He knows about sorrow, right? Because they drink sorrow.
Yeah.
Sapporo.
Sapporo.
Yeah, we drink that stuff.
Okay.
I just did, like, I had, like, a bunch of stuff planned, and, like, once I started going, like, it started shifting from the plan big time.
There it is. That's why we do it.
My plan was, it went a different way.
Nah, that's all right. Five fingers of death. That's what it's designed to do.
Hey, thank you, man.
That was dope.
I like that. Sunreal, man. You got so many callers on the
line,
too.
Where they calling from, Sway? Just run it down.
Okay,
where they calling from?
North Carolina, Savannah. Say what up, Savannah. Hey.
Hi there, Sunreal. How are you?
Hey, I'm good. So, how are you?
I'm doing likewise. So I'm from Raleigh, North Carolina, and my question to you, well, first of all, you are totally awesome. Love your music. I love the jazz background from the voicemail, but a quick question for you.
Yeah.
Who did your instrumental portion of that song while you were singing? Like, who did the background
Who produced it? It was my homie Trevor Muzzy and my homie Pops. Trevor Muzzy produced my entire album. He's an incredible producer. Pops is an incredible producer, too, and they both worked on that song.
Savannah, great question. You're a citizen, Savannah.
Good morning.
You're a citizen. We got Damon in Oregon, Mo in Florida, Tony in Cali, Alex on the West Coast.
Woo.
They all calling for Sunreal. I'm going to tell all the citizens, hit them up directly. Mention that you heard him on the show. He'll respond to you. Tell him how they can hit you, bro.
You guys can hit me if you just type in Sunreal on any, like Instagram, Twitter, anything like that. Sonreal. You can get at me there. And, YouTube me. I got a lot of music videos. But most of all, I just dropped an album called The Aaron LP. It's my best work to date. I'm really, really, really proud of it. And I thank you guys so much for having me on here to express
all
it
love,
and
man.
Let people know.
All
and
love,
you've been plugging the album, like, super hard, man. I was going to plug it, like, so hard. But, like, Sway just got my back like that. So I've just been, like, listen to the man.
Oh man, listen, you got Jesse Reyes on the Healing track. That sounds really great. I'm a Jesse Reyes fan.
Yeah.
There's another track on it too called Back to You that we're gonna end with that I really enjoy too. I like the way that track sounds. Who produced that one?
That's Trevor Muzzy. He produced that in Pops actually again. So okay. Trevor Muzzy and Pops did voicemail, and Trevor Muzzy and Pops both did Back to You. but yeah, Trevor's like and Pops, but like, yeah, just Trevor's just a beast. He executive produced the whole album. So anything you hear on there is produced in some way by Trevor Muzzy, and he mixed the whole album, and he even mastered some of the songs. So
Trevor, man, that's the man right there.
Yep.
Continued success, Sunreal, ladies and gentlemen. Sway the morning.
Hey,
this one is called Back to You, Shade 4-5 off the Aaron LP.